please bow your heads with me. Heavenly Father, thank you for letting us be able to come together tonight in celebration of our graduation and the next chapter of our lives. We thank you for blessing us to be able to reach this point. Bless everyone here today. Lord, please calm all the nerves and anxiety of everyone and fill them with the excitement for starting their new path. Lord, let your presence be with us each and every day so that we may draw near to you and choose the right path you have for us. Guide us with every struggle and give us the courage to face all the challenges we may encounter. Be a light for our paths and show us your will for our futures. May we carry all the teachings we have learned to our everyday lives. Thank you for all the friends and memories we have made, and may we cherish the bonds we have made through the years with our classmates and our friends. We thank you for our parents and teachers who've worked so hard for us to be able to be where we are now. Bless us as we move to the next phase of life. Lord, let us always remember to rely on you and your plans for us in every decision we make. Thank you for this incredible senior class before me who are going to do great and amazing things. In your heavenly name I pray, amen. You may be seated.
Good evening. I am Chad Jordan, high school principal. On behalf of the Greene County Tech School Board, administration, faculty, and staff, I would like to welcome each of you to the 2022 Greene County Tech High School commencement exercises. In the trenches of this stressful year, our teachers have been with your students every step of the way. Through many tears and frustrations, they have stood tall through the unprecedented time in education. They have worked diligently to ensure every student would have a chance to be present tonight to receive their diploma. Would the teachers that are present tonight please stand to be recognized? Thank you. You can be seated. At this time, I would like to recognize the parents, guardians, and grandparents of the graduates. You have been with your students through all the good and bad times that life has thrown at them to this point. You have encouraged them to keep moving forward even through the toughest of times and celebrated their every victory through the best of times. I want to thank every one of you for your sacrifices and the major role you have played in getting these graduates to this point in their lives. We at Greene County Tech School District appreciate all you have done. If you are a parent, guardian, or grandparent of one of the graduates, please stand as we applaud your efforts and sacrifices. Thank you. You can be seated. This year, the senior class has 234 graduates, and they are the 75th graduating class at Greene County Tech. These graduates have been awarded over $4.5 million in scholarship money to date, and the number is still rising as the scholarships are still coming in. Join me in applauding such high academic achievement. Seniors, all the people in the arena tonight are here to celebrate the class of 2022, and this is your shining moment of accomplishment for a job well done. And now, please enjoy the evening.
My name is Riley Branch, and it is a great honor to be here today. I want to welcome students, teachers, administrators, staff, friends, and family to the day we've joyfully awaited, yet anticipated with great apprehension since walking into the doors of Greene County Tech High School for the first time. 2022 came a lot faster than I ever thought possible, and I think everyone here can agree, even our family members crying up in their seats. Today not only symbolizes what's to come of our past, what's to come of our future, but all the accomplishments and circumstances of our past. Today is for all the memories and experiences that have made us who we are and all the people we've met along the way. Today is for the Friday Night Lights and winning the bell, for the halftime band performances that we all cheered for the pep rallies and the homecoming skits that only we could understand, for that time I decided to run cross country. Not a good idea. For the nights we stormed the locker rooms after winning big basketball games, for prom and our night in paradise, and every little moment in between. It has been quite a journey, to say the least, and it's comforting to know that we did it all together. Our class colors of emerald green and lavender signify the journey that has shaped who we have become throughout these last 13 years. For us, emerald represents the abundance of opportunities we have been given and will encounter, and the prosperity and growth that has and will continue to unfold within each and every one of us. Lavender shares the idea of purity and grace as we enter this world of limitless possibilities and devotion, which will push us to be the best that we can be. Our flower, the tiger lily, is known as a symbol of protection against harm. This strongly resonates with our class due to the obstacles we have overcome throughout our years in high school. Not only were we forced to face circumstances that put us in a position to have a not-so-normal high school experience, we also faced the struggles of everyday life and simply being a teen in today's world. Trying to find out who you are while trying to complete an assignment at the same time can be very difficult. And I'm not sure if this is true for everyone, but there were many, 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 many late nights, and maybe, just maybe, a couple of tears shed for homework that now just seems so very minuscule compared to what is standing ahead of me. No matter what you have faced or overcome, we all can trust that we have been provided with the protection needed to face the ever-growing obstacles of life. The song "Best Day of My Life" by the American Authors was chosen as our class song. And although it sounds contradicting to some of our feelings about this day, it provides an important truth. The one verse that I found that best fit is when the song states, "All the possibilities, no limits, just epiphanies." It's terrifying to admit, but today marks the beginning of the rest of our lives. We will achieve, we will fail, we will love, and we will lose. But there are no limits on what we can do and the possibilities that this new chapter will bring. Today, it all becomes a reality, which brings me to our class motto. Don't cry because it's over, smile because it happened, which means just what it says. Although we will sadly leave behind everything that we have known and some of the people we love, we will always remember this time in our lives and the moments that made this experience so special. My dad quoted this to me the night my team and I lost our chance to go to state. And the season was pretty much over for us. It helped me to understand that everything must come to an end, but I must make the most of every second. Basketball has been one of the most important areas of my life, so letting it go is probably one of the hardest things I've ever done. I worked extremely hard to get where I did. I reached goals I set for myself, made countless memories, learned lifelong lessons, and made the most amazing friends. We have all been a part of something that has made us who we are, and the challenges and successes only make us more prepared to enter the next chapter of our lives. To sum this up, I want to thank everyone who has helped me get to this point. I want to thank my teachers for giving me a strong education throughout the years. I want to thank my basketball team and coaches for pushing me and giving me lasting friendships. I want to thank my very best friends for always being by my side and probably knowing me better than I know myself. I want to thank my brothers for always making me laugh, although I'm sure they don't even want to be here today. I want to thank my Aunt Leah for giving me amazing advice. I want to thank my grandparents for spoiling me and giving me great wisdom. I want to thank my parents for preaching that I can do whatever I set my mind to and handle every situation with grace, even when it's not easy. Most importantly, I want to thank God for all he has done in my life. It would be a shame to think of today as a sad day when this journey has been filled with such joyful memories. Everything must come to an end, but if we really look back, we will see that those memories only lead us to the start of the next beautiful adventure. Louis L'Amour once said, There will come a time when you believe everything is finished, yet that will be the beginning. Today is just the beginning, class of 2022, and I can't wait to see what we all accomplish. Congratulations, everyone, and thank you.
Success, by definition, is the accomplishment of an aim or purpose. Tonight is the culmination of the success we've worked towards the past 13 years of our lives. I'd like to thank God and our families. Without them, none of this would be possible. As children, we were taught about success from our parents. At one, it was learning how to walk. At five, it was walking into kindergarten without crying. At 10, success was having friends of our own. At 14, it was making that team you try so hard for. At 16, everyone wanted to get their driver's license. And 18, here we are at graduation. When we leave here tonight, we have the ability to determine our own future and decide what success means for us. Herman Cain once said, "Success is not the key to happiness. Happiness is the key to success. If you love what you are doing, you will be successful." So find what you're passionate about and do it. Success will not come without failure, but if we can learn from our past and move forward with determination, anything is possible. After all, haven't we all failed at some point leading up to today? I've been fortunate enough throughout my life to have parents that always encouraged me and told me I could do anything. When I was disappointed in my failures, they'd remind me that I was my biggest competition and that I could do anything I set my mind to. So believe in yourself. And when you can't believe in yourself, don't be afraid to lean on others who believe for you. Ronald Reagan once said, "There is no limit to the amount of good you can do if you don't care who gets the credit." So be an encourager of others and travel the road of success together. Your success will come from your attitude and determination, never from the failures of the others around you. I have been fortunate to be surrounded by strong people throughout my life, but two people in particular stand out. My grandmother became an amputee in her 60s around the time I was born. She was wheelchair-bound until she learned how to walk again, but she never let that stand in the way of her relationships or goals. Around age 70, she battled breast cancer. Never once did she worry about herself. Only others who were affected by her diagnosis. Just one phone call away and she'd leave all her troubles behind to help others conquer their own. The second is my Papa George. He had a heart attack long before I was born and was disabled all my life. But you'd never know by looking at his determination. He is 86 years old and to this day, he can tell you how to fix anything. As a matter of fact, if you're doing it wrong, he'll probably show you how it's done. Over the years, he's been my biggest encourager. Even while battling cancer himself, he was still the man who anyone could come to for help. You see, that's where I get my determination and strength. Never giving up is in my blood, and nothing can stand in my way. Papa, I'm glad you were able to make it tonight, and I'm proud to call you mine. Many times we've looked at the worldly possessions of others and thought, "Oh, they're successful. Look at that car," or "Look at their house." But as I've spoken to some of the older generations about success, I've seen a different perspective through their eyes. Not one person has said their success is what they have. Rather, it's what they leave behind. It's family, faith, and friendship. Success is the legacy they leave behind for the next generation. So as we go our separate ways tonight, I want to ask each of you, what will your legacy be? They may not remember what you did, but they will remember how you made them feel. I read this quote on a poster on Miss Ritter's wall, and it stuck with me. It reminds me of someone who I used to look up to, who everyone considered to be the nicest person. When I thought about what set them apart, I realized that it was because they always took time out of their day to talk to anyone and everyone. They invested into every person around them and made people feel like they were worth something. That person, Hunter Massing, is who I am now blessed to call my best friend and boyfriend, and he still talks to every person he meets like an old friend. People remember how you make them feel. As I reflect over the years, I am reminded of those people who made me feel like I belonged in the moments when I felt so out of place. I'll admit that to be in this spot as third, I often neglected my social life. I spent countless nights stressing and worrying over homework and grades. But throughout all the stress and chaos, my family was always there to remind me that everything was going to be okay. And although I do have regrets about sacrificing so much of my social life for academics, I've learned a lot from it. When I finally realized the value of relationships, I stopped taking advantage of having the people around me. I began to get to know my teachers and the staff around the school. By just sparking a simple conversation, I have discovered many friendships that I would have missed out on. Taking the time to talk to our custodians, Miss Patty and Miss Marita, was the best thing I did this year. And if you never talk to these sweet ladies, then you really missed out. I will always remember their kindness to me, as well as every welcoming smile of the staff of Greene County Tech. The last few years have been anything but easy, but ultimately, the thing that got me through was family. When I use the word family, I think not only of the people who share my genetics, but also of each relationship that has made me into who I am today. I think of my softball team, who fought together last week to make Tech history as the first state finalist. By the way, we play at 7 tomorrow night, so come out and support us and watch us take state. I also think of the band who spent countless hours working together to create something much greater than ourselves. My church, who invested into my childhood and helped build the foundation of my faith. The teachers and staff who invested their time and effort into my education and well-being. And the custodians who have become some of my best friends. From the people who physically raised me, as well as every person who has invested into me, I feel as though I carry a piece of each of those people, and therefore, to me, they are a family. I want to take a moment to thank my blood family now. To my grandparents, Gigi and Granddaddy, thank you for always spoiling me and making holidays special. Thank you for keeping the freezer full of popsicles and for pushing me and my cousins on the swing set for hours. I am grateful for your love and for all the meals you have made for us and the laughter we have shared. To my sister, thank you for being by my side since I was born. You have always been around to pat my face and show your love for me. I truly enjoyed the year we had together in band playing piano side by side. You're the best big sister I could ask for. I am so proud of who you are becoming, and I can't wait to see what you will do after you graduate college next year. To my dad, thank you for all the sacrifices you've made and the effort you put forth to be at nearly every single event that I was a part of. You have always been my biggest fan. Thank you for being the rock of our family and for showing me that life is not about the mistakes, but about the recovery. Thank you for all the wisdom you've poured into me and for all the fishing trips, softball weekends, and family vacations you made possible. To my mom, thank you for teaching me how to love others. The way you have impacted so many people truly inspires me to be like you. You have been the best example of faith throughout battling cancer as well as the daily battles you face. Thank you for loving me through each stage of childhood and for all the values you have instilled in me. Thank you for each and every prayer you have prayed for me, for the older I get, the more I understand the power of a mama's prayer. I hope you know how special you are. And to the rest of my family, thank you for all the love and support you have poured into me. Thank you for all the prayers you prayed and sacrifices you've made. I can say without a doubt that I wouldn't be where I am today without your wisdom and guidance. I am so thankful for each and every one of you. Now to my classmates. Thank you for being a part of my journey. I will always cherish the memories we have together, and I look forward to seeing the incredible people you will become. I am honored to stand in front of you and speak to you one final time. If you look around the room right now, I promise you there are so many people in here who love you and care about you. Don't forget to thank them. There are also many people you have yet to meet that will become family to you throughout your journey. Don't miss out on those relationships. Get to know the people around you. Pay attention to the way you make people feel. And cherish the time you have with your family. It's the best thing you'll ever do. Class of 2022, I love you all. May the Lord be with you in your next chapter of life. Thank you.
Congratulations, GCT Class of 2022. We did it. We made it to graduation day, the day we've been working towards for over a decade. We finally get to walk across the stage and turn our tassels, but we can't forget how we got here and the people who helped us along the way. We may be the ones in caps and gowns, but tonight is for our parents, our teachers, our coaches, and the countless others who have molded us into the people we have grown to be. Parents and teachers, you raised kind, respectful, intelligent kids and turned them into admirable young adults. So thank you and congratulations. Class of 2022, you are amazing. I am so grateful to have grown up alongside each of you and am honored to represent our class here tonight. These past few weeks, as high school was coming to an end, I have realized how far we have come. How did we so quickly go from kindergartners learning to read to young adults driving ourselves to take AP physics and calculus exams? We were walking on the field for the first time in eighth grade, then suddenly we blinked and we're coming off the basketball court for the last time. Tonight marks the end of our time at GCT, but when we look back, we'll smile and laugh and everything in between. We will smile when we think about the Brian Kinder concerts at the primary and beating Paradol 65-0 on senior night. We will laugh about flying shoes at our sophomore Veterans Day program and fainting on seventh grade field trips. We will sing along to the periodic table song Miss Randleman played for us and to the math songs Miss Ritter sang practically every day. We will miss the faculty homecoming skits and hearing "It's a Great Day to Be an Eagle" on the morning announcements. But most importantly, we will be filled with joy when we remember all of the wonderful friends we made over the years. Class of 22, thank you for all the memories. We are a resourceful, determined, compassionate group, and I cannot wait to see each of you achieve your dreams. When I look back on my time at GCT, I already know I will always be able to recite by heart the advice my mom told me every day as she dropped me off at school in the morning. Study hard, learn lots, make a difference, be a friend. I carried my mom's words with me every day while at school. Even when I started driving myself to school, my mom's advice guided me to always put forth my best effort and to be kind to all. Although we are graduating, I will still use these words to guide me through life, now until the day I die. Class of 22, if you study hard, learn lots, make a difference in being a friend, you can reach the stars.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Jared Noel, and I'm honored to be the valedictorian of the class of 2022. Before I begin my speech, I want to make a quick disclaimer. If you don't like the speech, my sister wrote it. If you do like it, it was all me. The topic I was given for this speech is the future, which is unfortunate because I know nothing about it. Unlike many former graduating classes, we are leaving high school with very limited real-life experience. Our most formative and impressionable years were spent in lockdown, so our sense of connection with the world is based on our time spent separated from it. Despite our inexperience with the ways of the world, we are the newest batch of workers, innovators, and thinkers that will keep it running. English novelist Graham Greene said, "There is always one moment in childhood when the door opens and lets the future in." Class of 2022, tonight is that moment for us. The fact that the future of the world lies in our hands might have some people feeling scared. As I look out at my classmates tonight, I can see where these people are coming from. Fortunately, though, our past experiences do not necessarily foreshadow our future, even though Ms. Bain might attempt to convince us otherwise. Our unique experiences will not hinder us from success, but have provided us with the necessary tools to be successful. After all, not many other classes have had to switch to an all-new form of learning halfway through high school. How many other classes can operate Zoom as well as us? How many other classes can make pajamas fashionable on camera like we can? We may have attended all of our online classes while our moms were washing dishes, dads were checking the firmness of the couch, and little siblings were being loud and obnoxious, but at least now we know how to multitask. Our distinct high school experience has equipped us with a very unique set of skills, and I'm confident that these skills will help us be successful in our future. With that, it is important to note that success is relative. In our futures, we must not let societal dogma lead us astray. According to Oxford Dictionary, a dogma is a principle or set of principles laid down by an authority as incontrovertibly true. However, no one is forcing us to follow this predetermined plan. Personally, I'm going to college to pursue a degree. Some of you, however, are braver than I and will be striving for your notion of success straight out of high school. This variability in life paths is what makes the real world so exciting. But no matter what path you'll be taking, I want to remind you that only you know what is best for you. Steve Jobs said it best when he said, "Have the courage to follow your heart and intuition, for they somehow already know what you truly want to become." In other words, you are the only one who knows who you want to be or what you want to do. Most likely, your own self-fulfillment cannot be obtained simply by following the socially acceptable path. Instead, if you believe in yourself and follow your heart, not even the sky can limit you. But having limitless opportunities does not necessarily mean you should strive after each and every one. In doing so, you would surely miss the little things that make life special. So far for me, these little things include MJ's lunchtime dance-offs and being interrogated about my good things every day. As I get older, they might be starting a family of my own or never sharing good things again. Yours may be different, but these are the experiences that will give your life meaning, so it is never worth it to abandon them to chase your dreams. That being said, always work to find the right balance between achieving your goals and having a life. A quote that has stuck with me as I've grown up is, "Live life like there is no tomorrow." Although this is cliche, it is still very meaningful. We have seen how disheartening it is to be stuck and not able to live life to the fullest. During our time spent separated from the world, we learn to treasure the small moments in life and to seize every opportunity for a new memory. So I want to encourage you all tonight to always stay true to yourself, no matter what others tell you, and chase your dreams, but never forget to save time for the little things that make life meaningful, because we never know when they'll be gone. After that spill, I think I might become a motivational speaker instead of going to college. I also want to recognize that no matter how strong and capable we are, we can do nothing without the help and guidance of those around us. So I would like to take some time now to thank those who have helped me reach this point. First, to our administrators, including all principals and school board members, thank you for guiding our district. Next, to the custodians, cafeteria workers, and groundkeepers at all buildings, thank you for providing us with a clean, beautiful place to learn. To all my teachers throughout the years, thank you for caring about me and nurturing me. You all have always shown up, even when it was difficult. I would also like to recognize specific teachers who have made a profound impact on me. First, to Ms. Ritter, thank you for never giving up on us, even when calculus got hard. To Professor Davis, thank you for sharing your passions and for encouraging us to find ours. To Ms. Bain, thank you for your dedication and commitment to organizing our senior events. To Ms. Sullivan, thank you for finally getting a new tooth. But seriously, thank you for being a breath of fresh air each day. To the GEOs, there is no way I could sufficiently thank you for the impact you have made in my life. Arguably, the most valuable lesson I learned, though, is the importance of getting broken fingers checked out by a doctor. Next, I would like to thank my parents, grandparents, sisters, and all other family for always loving me. I would most definitely not be here today without your constant support. And finally, to you, class of 2022, thank you all for being such a fun class to grow up with. You all have made these 13 years some I will never forget. Thank you.
The senior class of 2022 would like to make a special presentation in remembrance of one of their classmates. At this time, senior Adrian Bright will present an honorary cap and gown to the family of Brianna Scott. Please join me in a moment of silence to honor the family and memory of Brianna Scott. First row of graduates, please stand for the presentation of the diplomas. Jared Luke Knoll, valedictorian. Abigail Nicole Winger, salutatorian. Hannah Grace Stallings. Madison Alexis Mitchell. Riley Beth Branch.
I think it'll stay, but there you go.
Kylie Lynn Stokes. Kate Conley Young. Abby Ryan Dunn. Mariah Leanne Hodge. Alexis Don McKenzie. Avery Brooke Newsom. Madison Sierra Rouse. Emma Nicole Bates. Alexis Bailey Brewer. Emma Grace Lovell. Olivia Melina Ward. Savannah Nicole Campbell. Sierra Sky Floyd. Eric Blaine Stokes. Sarah Renee Stacks. Carly Joe McCarty. Cade Wesley Nelson. Maddie Claire Burke. Joshua Caleb Nelson. Henry Lee Mahan. Carly Paige Thompson. Andrew Logan Walker. Gage McFadden Mays Snyder. Yes. Lillian Addison Glidewell. Dylan James Woodson. Kaylee Cheyenne Runyon. Jackson Wesley Vaughn. Jasmine Nui Tran. Emma Ruth Copeland. Martin Brody Val. Bailey Anna Kay Heiser. Jace Daniel Shear. Audrey Kathleen Williams. Laura Lynn Sims. Abby Della Schifano. Carly Michelle Hollis. Caitlin Ann Marie Dancer. Alexanne Isabel Kellett. Christian Andrew Barber. Reese Christopher Middleton. Alexis Taylor Terrell. Nicholas Micaiah South. Dustin Alexander Henson. Allie J. Lewis. Lindy Reese Martin. Caitlin Grace Settemeyer. Drew Christian Laubach. Lauren Elizabeth Clark. Riley Walker McMains. Susanna Ruth Bishop. Seth Daniel Gray. Christian Wade Walls. Caleb Van Smith. Thank you, Caleb. Adrian Bailey Bright. Vanessa Jean Lee Holzer. Xander Chase Lancaster. Ethan Connor Wilson. Delaney Michelle Aaron. Shelby Ann Aaron. Lonnie Odell Akers. Jeffrey Scott Aswell. Case Taylor Austin. Sammy Joe Ballard. Jax Andrews Batten. Danica Marie Bacham. Austin James Beauregard. Natalie Renee Beckner. Nicholas Ian Bell. Colby Lee Benton. Brianna Lynn Bobo. Isaac Miguel Bowling. Brandon Lee Bolt. Caleb Vincent Bonds.
Seems like a better place to put this.
Asa Hernandez Booker. Connor Michael Bottoms. Emmy Bell Brasher. Skylar Jade Brown. Taylor J. Grace Brown. Christian Daniel Bruner. Gracelyn Madison Bruner. Haley Marie Buckley. Dennis Kenley Burgess. Landon James Calhoun. Jackson Britt Camp. Sergio Herejan Cedino Jr. Connor James Claremont. Sarah Beth Klein. Aspen Bailey Koffel. Brody Wilson Koffel. Chandler Drake Cole. Alyssa Elizabeth Combs. Emily Leanne Cope. Lillian Faith Crawford. Colin Jace Crosno. Neely Shea Darty. Haley Jade Davis. Roman Joseph DeBent. Joshua Lynn Deal. Zane Adam Wayne Deal. Emily Alicia Duncan. Zachary Stephen Fairchild. William James Fisher. Gabrielle K. Flatt. Humberto Beto Flores. Chloe Lynn Forbus. Keeper Clinton Forkum. Mahala Brooke Franklin. Arian Noel Freeman. Celeste Alexandria Gilliam. Connor Ull Glickert. Michaela Danielle Goldinger. Ethan Alexander Gooch. Alexander Wayne Goodman. Landon Bryce Gordon. Brandon Lee Scott Graft. Jace Braden Greenway. Payne Christopher Greer. Lacey Denise Gregg. Dallas Wayne Grimes. Brooke Cheyenne Haney. Thomas James Harmon. Devin Cage Hensley. Jaden River Henson. Logan Thomas Hickox. Aaron Lee Hicks. Zachary Ace Higdon. Landon Carter Hill. Macy Nicole Hines. Brandon Reese Hobbs. Colin Lucas Kent Hoggard. Austin Ray Hollingsworth. Nathan William Hollis. Morgan Lee Hooks. Lillian Marie Hull. Gavin Dobry Scott Howe. Joshua Bradley J.B. Hoyer. Dalton Cole Hubbard. Ethan Thomas Hufstetler. Hannah Grace Jackson. Jasmine Faye Jacobs. Addie Noelle Keith. Archlyn Valora King. Nathaniel Thomas LeBlanc. Cameron Lance Lee. Marcus Alexander Lim. Abby Jane Linderman. Tatiana Lisbeth Lovo. Presley Aaron Lowe. Tristan Allen Lyles. Spencer Patrick Magel. Madison Lynn Maggard. Braden Taino Marrero. Kenley Shea Matlock. Laura Sue McDaniel. Landon Christopher McDowell. McCaglin Shay Merrill. Thank you. Cadence Blair Miller. Elizabeth Grace Milligan. Nicholas Matthew Moran. Kenneth Angelo Moss. Zachary Tyler Murphy. Aiden Wilson Owens. Ethan Jung Pack. Eric David Pangborn. Kaylee Nicole Payne. Jackson Seth Pegg. Mackenzie Danielle Raper. Alexis Resendez. Zane Michael Revel. Elizabeth Kayla Ring. Erica Lynn Reisner. Robert Eugene L.B. Robinson, Jr. Jose Francisco Rodriguez. Carson Zachary Rogers. Dakota Jack Barron Rogers. Jacqueline Eileen Rogers. Matthew Ethan Rollins. Lexi Ray Romero. Austin Carl Rudy. Haley Danae Russell. Alexis Jade Sessoms. Luke Paul Shinkirik. Dylan Matthew Schultz. Angel Ray Silva. Logan Lee Simmons. Andrew Thomas Simpson. Damian Alexander Smallman. Olivia Ray Smith. George Smith III. Fisher Jaden Sparks. Chasen Lee Storms. Zane Rice Stricker. Cheyenne Brooke Ashland Strope. Jonathan Blaine Sullinger. Madison Storm Tankersley. David Michael Tarleton. Larisha Yvette Taylor. Tanaya Yvette Taylor. Nanzana K. Tidwell. J. James Tinsley. Joshua Langham Tao. Clinton Cole Tucker. Caden Nicholas Tyler. Claire Alyssa Tyler. Daniel Jasper Van Slyke. Bridger Stephen Vines. Trevor Daniel Warhurst. Wesley Allen Watkins. Caleb Andrew Watson. Antonio Curtis Webster. Luke Daniel Wells. Gavin Tyler West. Kenneth Richard Lee West. Dallas Lee Wheaton. Blake Evan Wheeler. Kirtland Shea Wilcox. Brian Denton Williams. Drake Anthony Williams. Victoria Diane Wilson. Elizabeth Ann Wright. Jonathan Cornelius Wright. Justin Lane Young. If you didn't know, these are all tardy slips. I guess they got a bunch of tardies this year. Graduates, please stand. You may now turn your tassel.
Ladies and gentlemen, I now present the Green County Tech High School graduating class of 2022.